Hey everybody, Teresa here. Welcome back to my channel, Lost My Thread. Today I'm going to be reflecting on what Me Made May was like for me in 2021. I would imagine if you're watching this video, you probably already know what Me Made May is, but just in case you don't, it was a challenge set up by Zoe of Sozo Blog, and the challenge was originally just for her, for herself, to challenge herself to wear her Me Made clothes in the month of May, and it is now much bigger and beyond that. And the idea is that each person makes a personal pledge about something they want to do around their Me Made wardrobe in the month of May, and they can share details about that on Instagram or on her blog, or it can just be something you do personally for yourself. A lot of people choose to wear at least one Me Made item every day. Some people wear top to toe Me Made every day in May, and a lot of people like to share photos of that on Instagram as well. I did wear one item of Me Made clothes every day in May. That was my challenge that I set for myself, and I also wanted to reflect on that regularly, including this video now. As I was doing these reflections, I think it was maybe about 2.5 weeks into it, I looked back at what I'd been wearing in May and realized that I had actually worn a unique Me Made item every day up till that point. I had some repeating ones when I'd mixed and matched, but each day had something that was a new Me Made item that I hadn't shared before. And I felt like, well, if I've done it this far, I might as well continue. I do have more than 31 items of Me Made clothes, so I knew that I could theoretically get through the whole month with a new item each day. And so I decided just to carry on and do that as a kind of additional challenge for the rest of the month. So I took a photo every day in May and I posted it in my Instagram stories, and I did a roundup at the end of every week, but I'm just gonna fly through and show you my Me Made clothes for the whole month of May. Thank you. As I was reflecting and thinking about what I enjoyed wearing, what I was gravitating towards, what I kept wanting to wear again and again, one that came up was jumpsuits. I really love wearing jumpsuits. There's something about them that they're very comfortable and relaxed, but they also just feel really together. I mean, I feel like that with dresses. I like wearing dresses because it's just one piece. You don't have to think about different tops, bottoms, mixing and matching. You just put it on and it's done. And jumpsuits have that, but I think because it's the trouser bit as well, there's just a feeling of just being really together. I feel like I'm very organized when I'm wearing a jumpsuit. It's probably really bizarre, but this is how I feel. So I have really loved wearing my jumpsuits, and that was one of the things that I felt like I wanted to wear again, but I didn't have enough to wear as many as I wanted to, and I didn't want to repeat them this month. So I do need to make more jumpsuits. I have already cut out another jumpsuit that I had been planning anyway. It's a Zadie jumpsuit, and I will be hopefully making that one up pretty soon. It's all cut out and ready to go. But yeah, I need to make more jumpsuits in general. And the other thing I think that's really important for me to think about with my sewing is that dresses are the one item of clothing that I just get the most joy out of wearing. I feel so happy and light and pretty and fun in a dress. I just love dresses, and I do sometimes feel like I need to focus more on separates, or I need to do more of, you know, jumpsuits, accessories, all these kinds of things, and I feel like I sort of shy away in my mind from making dresses. Having said that, I'm always making dresses, so it's not only so effective, but there's something, maybe a little bit of guilt about making more dresses, because I know I don't really need more dresses, but I know that I'll really enjoy making them, and I know that I'll love wearing them. So I feel like I'm trying to grab what I can as far as the joy of sewing and keep that in the future. So I'm gonna try and be less guilty about making dresses, because I know how much I really enjoy wearing them, and I enjoy looking at pictures of myself in them. I just feel like myself. I love a dress, so I'm gonna make more dresses and I'm not gonna feel bad. And one item that I didn't really show as often as I wore it is the Blackwood cardigan. So that was my black viscose jersey, merino wool jersey, sorry, long Blackwood cardigan that was black, that just goes with everything. The style of that cardigan is so good. So that's the Helen's Closet Blackwood cardigan. I mean, there's so many around over on the sewing community on Instagram and on YouTube. I know you'll have seen those before. It's such a classic style. But I feel like it goes with things that are more dressed up and more dressed down. It's so comfortable. The sort of width of the sleeve, the length of the sleeve is so cozy. It feels so great to wear. So I did reach for that a lot. So I did decide that I needed to make another Blackwood cardigan, because I know it's such a great pairing piece. It's such a great additional accessory. So I have also cut out fabric for another Blackwood cardigan. This one is a gray. I thought a neutral was really good, so it's like a pale gray. It will go with so much, and I know that it's gonna be a really just staple garment in my wardrobe. It was also interesting that I didn't wear a ton of ready-to-wear clothes, which I didn't expect to be the case. I think last May I wore quite a lot of still ready-to-wear, but I've been making more bottoms and separates and things this year. I think next year I should be able to wear head-to-toe me-made without any repeats, without any issues. So I think that's probably what I'll end up doing. But this year I did have a few just, you know, random ready-to-wear things that I wore, and I wanted to think a bit about what those were and if I have just plans or desires to make those things for myself, because I am currently in a situation where I don't want to buy any more ready-to-wear clothes. As soon as these things wear out, I'm going to need to make more for myself. So one of the things that I did wear that was ready-to-wear were skinny jeans. I have already the ginger jeans pattern that I have made a failed attempt at making, and I'm going to be making another pair soon. But the ones that I wore in Me Made May were black skinny jeans, and I think I probably need to buy some black stretch denim, because I feel like those are just a really versatile garment and I wear them a lot, and they are definitely wearing. They're starting to wear a lot, particularly on the inside of the thighs. They're not that great quality, so I don't particularly feel like they're worth doing a whole load of mending and fixing, because they're only cheap anyway, but I do want to make some more for myself. So jeans are on the list. I'm going to make those. There was also a cute pair of shorts that I wear as pajamas that was made with a French terry, like a striped French terry. And I happen to have a very similar striped French terry that I used to make a sweatshirt recently, and I've got some left over, and I do think I have enough to make a copy of these shorts. And I think that would just be a really fun, cute project. The ones that I have are totally functional. They don't need replacing, but I like wearing them. They're really cute, especially like summertime, bedtime kind of thing, or lounging at home. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and make a copy of those. I was also thinking I probably do need to make some more shorts in general. I didn't really have a lot of shorts weather, so it didn't really matter to me. I like to wear shorts in the summer, especially on really hot days when you're getting all a bit sweaty and clammy and sticky between the legs. It can be really uncomfortable wearing a skirt. So I do like to have shorts as an option, and I could definitely do with some more pairs. I also have not made myself any kind of short cropped cardigans, and I wear those often with like fit and flare dresses or any kind of a dress really that's a bit more fitted in the bodice area, especially something that's sleeveless, because it's nice to have the option of covering up because weather changes in the day, but also it might be a bit sunny and you might want to cover up. And I've only ever had ready to wear versions of those. I know that there are some out and about, but I don't think any of them are particularly called out to me. I think the one that I like the look of the most is one from Cashmerette. I can't remember the name of it, so I'll put the name up on the screen so that you can see which one I mean. But that one looks good, but unfortunately I am slightly out of their size range. I'm a little bit smaller than their size range, but I know that they've been trying to extend all of their patterns to a lower size range, so I will be in there at some point. So I think once that pattern comes out in my size, I'll probably have a go at making that one as my kind of cropped cardigan. And one item that surprised me a little bit with how much I enjoyed wearing was my Winslow culottes, which are a Helen's Closet pattern again. The Winslow culottes, again, are a really popular pattern. They are a super wide leg, full culotte trousers with some really nice pleat details on the front and on the back. They're very high-waisted. I was very borderline about making these because they are quite high-waisted and I don't usually go for a high-waisted style, but I had so much fun wearing them because this is made in a tencel twill fabric. These ones, they really swoosh around in a wonderful way, and because they're so wide-legged, you feel like really you're wearing a skirt, but you have something between your legs. I don't know why, it's just a lot of fun. They're a lot of fun to wear. I made these in a pinstripe as well, which I think is a cool look. So I am gonna be wearing those again. I reached for those twice in May, and I could have easily worn them more often because it was a lot of fun, but like I said, I was trying not to wear the same patterns too much. I wanted to mix it up a little bit, but that one surprised me with how much I enjoyed it. And I think one of the things as well that I think was maybe the second time I was wearing it, I noticed that the waistband, the top of the waistband was really quite loose and away from my body. The bottom part of the waistband was perfect, but it's one of these like just straight up and down waistbands. It doesn't taper in at all, and my body tapers in a lot, particularly in that part of my body around the waist. So it just kind of sat a bit flappy at the top of the waistband. And so I decided to go ahead and just pinch out a little section on either side, the top of the waistband, and stitch that in place, almost like a little dart basically. And that just helped to curve it in a little bit at the sides. And I tell you, it made a world of difference. There was a funny thing with those culottes where basically they were always shifting around on my body. I think because they weren't really sitting against my body, they were kind of just propped on me. And every so often they kind of pull up my back and I get a little bit of a wedgy thing going on. They weren't the most comfortable things to wear. And I felt like, ooh, maybe I shortened the crotch curl a little bit too much, but they didn't feel like they sat in the wrong place, but they were shifting all the time. It sits on my body much better and it's not shifting around anymore. It just stays put. So no more wedgies. So it's a lot more comfortable and they're a lot more fun to wear. And I think that has been quietly in the back of my mind putting me off wearing those. And sometimes it's just the littlest changes that you need to make to suddenly make a garment so much more wearable. So I'm so glad that I did that. I want to wear these a lot more. The other thing I will say is I felt like when I first made them, I didn't have a ton of shirts or tops that went with them, but I've gradually been making more things that I think suit a higher waisted style trouser a lot more, so I feel like I'm gonna get more wear for that reason as well. The other things that I didn't show every day but I used a whole heck of a lot are my Kelly Anorak by Closet Core Patterns, and then also my Hillside Tote by Noodlehead Patterns. So basically my coat and my bag, they go with me pretty much everywhere. I wear them all the time, especially because May was so wet and so cold. My coat is waterproof and quilted on the inside, so it's super cozy, so I was wearing that loads. It was interesting just looking at the overall style for the month as well. I feel like there are a lot of people who have a super cohesive wardrobe where all of their clothes look like the same kind of tones. They can mix and match all these things together. And as much as I admire that and I think it's really amazing and beautiful, I feel like it doesn't really suit what I want for my wardrobe. I like having a more eclectic style. I like having neons and earthy tones and blacks and mixes of prints and fun prints and patterns. I just like to have the option of changing it up and wearing different stuff. It was really nice that I could tap into those different styles and enjoy something different about them. So that is something that I felt like, do I need to change? Do I want to change? And actually, I like that the way that it is. So I've got a whole mix of clothes that I have, that I wear, but I love them all, honestly. I really like being able to choose between all those very different items. One of the things that stood out to me this May, because there are a lot of things I've made a while ago now, it was the signs of wear, the signs of, I would say, love for these garments. The more you wear something, you're gonna start to notice areas where maybe it starts to fray, seams start to break, maybe the color start to fade a little bit. And sometimes I think that can really add to the look of the garment. It can look kind of cool and vintagey, or just cool and worn in and relaxed. One example of that is my Kali anorak. I really like how it's worn and gotten a little bit lighter and faded in certain areas where it's gotten rubbed, or I mean, I don't know quite how it wears away the way it does, but you know, you can get like worn in jeans and stuff like that, but this is naturally worn in by myself. Another one that I really love for that is my La Brea dress hack, I should say, which is a red linen. Linen is a kind of fabric that is very good for holding on to color, so it dyes really well and gets these really vibrant colors, but that color starts to gradually fade over time, and it starts to fade in certain areas. So it's faded a little bit around the neck binding, around the sleeve binding, around the pockets, and I really like the look of that. I think it looks really cool, and like I said, it looks like a loved, worn-in garment, and I really think it enhances the look of it. There are also times when it detracts from the look of it. So times when you don't particularly want the color to be fading on it. I've got some fabrics made in quilting weight cottons, and a lot of those have gradually started to lose their dye over time. But even though it's not necessarily making it look nicer, for me, it reminds me of how much I've worn it. It makes me feel like I'm really loving and using my me-made items, which makes me really happy. I want to make clothes that I wear, and I want to make clothes that gradually fade, tear, that I'm going to repair, that I'm going to just make the most out of. That's what I'm interested in doing for my wardrobe. So seeing evidence of that just makes me feel like I'm loving the clothes that I'm making. I've also done some mending jobs here and there when seams have broken or areas have started to fray. And I love seeing the evidence of that inside my garments when I put it on as well, because again, it's just kind of bringing to my attention and reminding me of what I'm doing to try and help and keep my clothing sustainable, do as much as I can to try to reduce waste, make my clothes last longer. But I'm really just doing that as well for selfish reasons, as far as like, I love these clothes and I want to keep wearing them. And if they're starting to fray, if they're starting to break down, I need to fix that so that I can wear them. Most of the things that I've mended, I will say, it's been more internal, so invisible things on like the inside of the seams and neck bands. But no matter what I've done to do those repairs, it's a way that I've helped that garment to last longer. And I've put something even more into those clothes to allow me to keep wearing them and keep getting joy out of them. Fortunately, I don't have much staining in general on my me-made clothes, though I'm kind of surprised because I do spill things on myself as much as everybody else, I'm sure. But I don't wear a whole lot of white, so that probably helps. I don't like to wear white for that reason. But one thing that I feel like is a memorable stain that I've got on my clothes that's not going anywhere is from my Kali anorak. So I mentioned that as an item of clothing that I wear all the time, particularly when it's chilly out because it's super cozy and warm. It was a project that I spent a lot of time on, a lot of time and energy. There were a lot of processes. Like I said, I quilted the lining, I waterproofed the seams after I stitched them in as well to make the whole thing really waterproof. It's made in a beautiful waxed cotton that I got from Guthrie and Ghani. And I feel like that was one that I felt very precious about, a bit protective of probably, which is a little bit silly because, you know, these clothes are made to be worn, but that was the way I felt. I'm a midwife and I had been visiting people in their homes who have been COVID positive throughout the pandemic. Whenever we visit somebody who is known to be COVID positive, we always take extra precautions. So one person waits outside. The person who goes in is obviously wearing full PPE and everything and generally going to be wearing their hospital scrubs. But when you come out of the person's house, you have to wipe down all of the equipment, wipe down your shoes because they've been in somebody's house, obviously clean your own hands and take off your mask and glove and apron and all of that. Now, I did at one visit have my Cali Anorak that I'd worn into the person's apartment building flat. We hadn't gone into the flat. I left my coat outside so that I could wash my hands and arms properly when I came out of the visit. But as I was washing everything down with our sort of disinfectant chlorine stuff, I bleached, or a little bit of bleach must have splashed onto the Cali Anorak, onto the pocket. And so there's a little bit of a bleach stain on the bottom of the hem and the bottom of one of the pockets. It's not a big stain by any means. I didn't even notice it at the time. I didn't notice it until it might have been that evening or the next day. And it did make me sad when I noticed that I had this bleach stain on this coat that I'd spent a lot of time, a lot of energy, put a lot of myself into. And I had to remind myself about my me-made items and why I make them and what they're for. As I said before, I am a midwife and I have worn a lot of my me-made clothes to home births before, which is potentially a bit risky, but I've never yet had any massive messes on my me-made items, but there's always a possibility that could happen. But I think the main thing is I'm not gonna be precious about those items. I want to wear them because they are the clothes that I like the most, that I feel the most comfortable in, that fit me, that I feel confident in, and that means that occasionally something's gonna happen to those clothes, and I accept that, and I see that as part of the garment's story and the, you know, my own story. In this particular case of the Cali Anorak, I've got this little mark now. My coat has been marked by COVID, as many of us have been marked by COVID in many ways, big and small ways. And I feel like that's just a little bit of a reminder for me. I'm gonna keep wearing this coat for years. That is very much my intention. This is my coat for a long time to come. And I will always see that little bleach stain as a little memory of what I've been through, what my coat's been through, what we've all been through throughout this pandemic. I know it's not always easy to have that kind of perspective, and of course, I have my moments where I don't necessarily keep that perspective, but this is something that I felt like was very strong for me throughout the month of May, and seeing all the ways that my clothing has changed, developed, aged over the years with my love and with my wear just made me really happy. I would love to hear other people's opinions on when and where they wear their me-mades and their attitudes around if and when their me-made items get a little bit damaged or stained or go through the life that we're all going through. So let me know in the comments down below what kind of experiences you've had with your me-made items. And let me know if you did take part in me-may-may as well, if there was any surprises that you found either with the clothes that you were wearing or the things that you were noticing as you were looking throughout the month. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more videos, please do subscribe. And if you liked my video today, a thumbs up is always appreciated and helps other people to be able to find the video as well. And I will see you guys very soon. Bye!